All right, so we'll move to the next question. Try solving this question, this one. Okay, so this is the viscous fluid. We actually ignore viscosity most of the time, but then since this is sphere in a viscous fluid, and if they have velocity, then there will be a viscous force also apart from the buoyant force. Buoyant force will of course act, but apart from that, there will be a viscous force also acting on it, which is given by this formula, 6 pi eta r to V terminal. Anyone got the answer? So few of you might have remembered the formula if it is just one sphere alone. So it is 2 by 9 pi r rho minus sigma times g divided by mu. Okay, this if you remember, it will be fine. Otherwise you can always derive it. Okay, so if let us say I'm talking about P, so I have to take the density of the P and the density of the fluid, let us say sigma 2, and we have coefficient of viscosity here. Okay, so two spheres of equal radii have density rho 1 and rho 2. The sphere are connected, L1, L2 are densities sigma 1 and sigma 2. So this is sigma 1 and this is sigma 2. Coefficient of viscosities are also eta 1 and eta 2. So if sphere P alone in L2, if P is alone in L2, then Vp is the velocity. So if P is in liquid 2, then you have to use liquid 2's density and liquid 2's coefficient of viscosity. Okay, similarly, Vq is Q alone in L1, which will be what, 2 by 9 pi r square rho 2 minus sigma 1 divided by eta 1. Okay, so this is how you get Vp and Vq, and now you can compare. First of all, sigma 2 has to be more than sigma 1, then only, this liquid will be at the bottom and the upper liquid will be at the top. Okay, so this is the first thing you should know. And the second thing which is there is density of the second, this thing, density of Q should be more than the density of the first liquid. Okay, then only the Q is submerged. Okay, Q is not in the first liquid, so Q is down. And also density of the second liquid has to be less than, oh wait, if string is taut, okay, and everything is sinking, if everything is sinking, then density of the second ball has to be more than the density of the second liquid as well. Okay, then only it will keep on going down with the velocity. Otherwise it will just float, it will not go down. Fine, so therefore you can say that rho 1 is less than sigma 1. Okay, and you have sigma 2 is less than rho 2. And we anyway have sigma 2 to be greater than sigma 1. Fine. So rho 1 is less than sigma 1 that is required. Otherwise, the string will not be taut. Okay. So Q is essentially pulling everything down. Q is making effort so that P comes down. So if Q doesn't make any effort, P will come, not come down. So basically there has to be a tension in the string. Okay, so if there is a tension in the string, and if you draw a free body diagram of P, let's say this is tension, okay, then you have mg force and you have the buoyant force. Okay, so mg is what? Density of the material into volume of the material into g. Buoyant force is density of the liquid into volume of liquid into g. Okay, so if suppose velocity is almost zero, so we can ignore the viscous force, then tension is required over and above the mg force. So it automatically means buoyant force is more than the mg force. Okay, then only it will be pulled down and then it will gain some velocity and then viscous force will also start acting. But prima facie, the density of liquid one has to be more than the weight. Sorry, density of liquid one has to be more than the density of P. Okay, so when you analyze all these scenario, you will get option A and D to be correct. Okay, so we'll move to the next question. We have around 15 minutes. Okay, let's take a question on surface tension. See, these questions, few are beyond mains level, but our focus is learning the concept. So that is why I'm making you a little uncomfortable with slightly difficult questions, but you will learn more. Try solving this one. Okay, Saimir and Purvik, I have left that question after analyzing the scenario. So I want you to get option A and D. I have told you the final answer, okay? So after that, it is nothing. You just spend some time, you'll get it. I wanted to discuss this question on surface tension. So that's why I'm not putting this one. So let me know, you can WhatsApp me if you're not getting and send me your attempt. Anyone got the fourth one? I think this fourth question is straightforward. Kushal, how are you getting C? Explain quickly. Acha, all of you know that surface tension T is force per unit length. Okay. And this is also surface energy per unit area. Okay. So let us say this is the drop. Which is formed on a dropper. Fine. Then let us say that this is the center. Okay. I am connecting the peripheries like this. Okay. Why I'm doing this? Because the surface tension will act on this circle, okay, which is from the dropper, okay, and along which direction it will act? It will act like this, okay. So if this is the surface tension, okay, which is trying to reduce the surface area, then let's say this is theta. Okay, so if this is surface tension T, so T cos theta, okay, T cos theta into 2 pi r, because this surface tension is acting on the entire of this circle, which is the end of the dropper. Okay, so T cos theta into 2 pi r will balance the weight. Okay, this is the vertical force. So we need to just find the vertical force only. Okay, and also we know that cos of theta is small r by capital R, where this is capital R. And if you draw a vertical line like this, this radius of the dropper is small r. Okay, so cos theta, where this is theta, then this angle, this yellow angle is 90 minus theta, then this angle will become angle theta. So cos of theta is small r by capital R. So this will give you vertical force to be equal to 2 pi r square t by small r. Okay, so even though I have said that this is very easy one, but it was not. It was a tricky one, which I'm sure many students who have seen this for the first time in the exam would not have got it. Okay, this is again a question which differentiates toppers from others. So don't worry if you're not able to get it. So just try to learn the concept here. What about fifth and sixth? Once you get the fourth one, see, these passage questions are, you know, they are linked from each other. If you get one of the question right, you will get all of them right, because one answer of the one will be used in the next question. So it will detach from the dropper when the vertical force become equal to mg, isn't it? And when it detaches, it will be almost spherical drop. Any answers for the fifth one? D. Purvik is getting D. Others?
So B.
B for Bombay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No. See, the vertical force is what? 2 pi r square t by capital R. Okay. So this should be equal to the weight of the drop, which is 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho into g, right? So from here, you'll get the radius of drop, and it will be approximately option A. Fine. What about the sixth one? Sixth, what is the answer? Sixth one is direct. Surface tension is surface energy per unit surface area as well. So you just multiply surface tension with surface area, you'll get the answer for surface energy. Okay. So you have got radius of the drop from here. All right. So R is equal to 1.4 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meters. So surface energy will be equal to surface tension, which is given as 0.11. So 0.11 into 4 pi R square, 1.4 into 10 raised to power minus 3 square. This many joules is the surface energy. Okay, so you'll get option B to be correct over here. Fine. So I think today I have made you little uneasy with this chapter by showing you different kind of questions that can be there other than your routine ones, which I have sort of intentionally not shown in this particular session, because I wanted you to be aware that there are few other varieties that exist other than what is there in HC Verma. Okay. So that's how you have to take care of the variety rather than the quantity when you practice questions yourself, right? That's it for today. So I hope you have learned many things today. What I'll do, I'll forward you this particular PDF, and few questions I have just given you hints so that you can solve it yourself. So immediately get the answer for those and WhatsApp me in case you don't get it. And yes, so we will come back to you again in couple of days with another session on revision. And this time I'm planning to take exclusively entire optics. So I think we have already one session on optics. Now the session will be slightly faster. We'll be solving other kinds of numericals on optics in the next class. Okay. Thank you for today. We'll see you
soon. Thank you, sir. Bye.